Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. This is the C13 T90, which is a new Italian light tank coming to the game with the next major update. The C13 is an IFV, it's just an IFV. Well, this is the C13 T90, so it's an IFV with a gun on it. The C13 is an IFV developed with the aim of producing a replacement to the outdated M113 APC in service with Italian forces at the time. Soon tankers in War Thunder will get the chance to command yet another excellent light tank and all that bullshit, arriving to the higher ranks of the Italian ground forces tree as part of the next major update. The C13 T90 is a light tank for Italy of the 4th rank. Pros that it has good mobility, cons that it has poor turret protection. Wow, fascinating. That's so much to go by. So briefly, it is an experimental 1980s Italian infantry fighting vehicle supporting good mobility and boasting great firepower thanks to its punchy 90mm cannon. And here we have some history on the unit if you are interested. And here we've got some screenshots. Not the prettiest looking vehicle, but I don't know. I think vehicles like this can be fun to play sometimes. And we've got two different paint schemes on it. In War Thunder, the C13 T90 will be a new light tank arriving to rank 4 of the Italian ground forces tree as part of the next major update direct hit coming to the game. Its devastating 90mm cannon, impressive mobility yet rather light armor make the C13 T90 a typical representative of the infantry fighting vehicle class of vehicles and thus a likely new favorite among seasoned Italian tankers. Let's give the newcomer a closer look, shall we? The C13 T90 sports quite a formidable primary arsenal in the shape of a 90mm... What? Cock. They put cock in the game. Mark III cannon, a weapon already familiar to some Italian tankers who may have commanded the 74, offering good handling characteristics and respectable ballistic properties with its heat and Hesh ammunition choices. The C13 T90 can easily pose a serious threat even to the most heavily armored adversary at its rank. Apart from packing a serious punch with its cannon, the C13 T90's ability to is also nothing short of impressive. Being powered by a 360 horsepower diesel engine, the C13 T90 can reach a top speed of 70 kilometers an hour under ideal conditions. With such a high top speed, and considering that the C13 T90 is a tracked vehicle, its mobility is quite comparable to some of its wheeled counterparts in the Italian tree, especially when taking into account the C13 T90's advantage in less hospitable terrain. Here we got some screen shits of the vehicle. There it's nice and brown and chocolate, and here it's kind of like chocolate, but it's mixed and kind of burnt, because you boiled it too long. And then here's the white, powdered donut flavor. Being an IFV by design at the end of the day means that the C13 T90 doesn't boast the best protection, however. Even though the vehicle does come outfitted with up to 50mm of aluminium or aluminum alloy. Oh, they spelt it aluminium here. I'm sorry, I was looking at it because I was actually going to say last time they spelt it aluminum, but they spelled it aluminium here. Alloy armor at its strongest points at the front section of the vehicle, the C13 T90 is unlikely to stop anything more powerful than autocannon fire at a distance. As a result, aspiring commanders of this machine will be ill-advised to take the C13 T90 into frontline brawls. Instead, commanders will be better off taking advantage of the vehicle's excellent mobility and scouting ability to outflank their opponents, launch surprise attacks from the enemy's rear, and keep their allies updated on hostile movements. So, maybe not the most exciting vehicle to, you know, that Italy could have. I'm still waiting for that Italian Panther tank, mind you. But I still think that it's kind of interesting looking. And there are vehicles on other tech trees that are kind of similar ideas of these weird light tanks that have guns put on them, or IFVs, mind you, that have not autocannons for once. And they can be a lot of fun to play. The only thing that I would say this thing looks like it could suffer from is the fact that it's a bulky vehicle. Like, the reason light tanks excel so much is because they're fast and small, and they have guns that can output damage. But when you have a nice, big, bulky IFV, you know, and not just a traditional light tank, that's going to make you an easier target to hit for anything that's shooting at you. Anyways, though, that's what Italy is so far getting in the next major update. I think they're also getting a new jet aircraft on the dev server. There was something new there, I think, but I don't know if it will get its own dev blog or not. Otherwise, that's all I think Italy is getting. Oh, they're getting some new naval forces stuff too, mind you. I forgot about that, my bad. Anyways, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder major upcoming coming time. What the fuck is wrong with me? Dude, I'm hungry. I haven't eaten in like 8 hours.